Are you good at keeping secrets?
Of course.
Why?
Because secrets are meant to be kept.
Can you keep a secret?
Yes, of course. Good.
I love things that are secretive, and submarine is something that is very interesting to me. Submarines is something that very few people get to work on. When I joined DSDA, Singapore did not even have a submarine. If you read on history, you will realize that submarines are strategic assets and has been pivotal in the World War. I've been in Singapore's submarine journey since 2001. We have three classes of submarines, the Challenger, the Archer and the Invincible, each with their own challenges and excitement. The Challenger class were originally built for the Swedish waters. The salinity of the water, the temperature and the expansion of matters are all very different. And we will have to learn all this in the hard way of how to customize the submarines to operate in our waters. I was working in Sweden for 3 years, working with some of the best submarine builders in the world. Submarines are complex and you cannot learn them from school. You have to spend time with the system, with the people and the operation to really understand how everything works. One example is waste management. Everything on board the submarine has to be kept until the end of the journey. So we have to prepare everything that we bring on board to minimize the waste. But even the food that we bring on board has no bones. It's detailed like this, things that you don't really think about, that make you realize how different the life underwater is. 10 years later, we added the Archer class submarines. With the experience that we have gained, we added a new section and packed it with advanced systems. Today, we are able to customize the Invincible class submarines. It is stealthier and quieter, and customize it for our waters so that it is more maneuverable and is able to perform more customized missions. My colleague Lai Peng is also another staff who has been involved from the start.
I'm Lai Peng. I'm the Senior Development Program Manager at DSDA. Back in 1999, I was tasked to develop the C3 system for the Challenger class submarine. C3 stands for Command, Control and Communication. Basically, it's the brain of the submarine. When the submarine is underwater, she cannot see and she has to rely on sensors such as the sonar system to know the surrounding. The C3 system helps the commander to make sense of all the information that's coming in. The C3 system uses algorithm to figure out where the other ships are and pulls everything together and give the commander a clear and updated picture of what's happening around the submarine. And this helps the commander in their decision making. In the beginning, we learn from established industrial partners. So over the years, we have come a long way. And now we are able to build our own indigenous C3 system that provides advanced features to RSN.
I will say that my job is a mix of science and art. It takes the science to solve the technical aspect of the problem, but also art in the sense that we need to design and optimize the space around the system for the operator to operate in. My biggest achievement is to be able to customize the submarines to meet the Singapore's unique operational needs. In the past, we can only purchase pre-owned submarines and the models and the design are fixed. Now we are able to instruct the submarine builder to customize the submarines to meet our operational needs, and that is the greatest achievement.
For me, I actually love doing engineering work. So DSDA is able to provide me with the opportunity to excel in this area. Because of the job nature, I also get to meet people from different countries and cultures. And this basically has added a lot of colors to my career.
It feels good to be regarded as one of the most knowledgeable in the field. But beyond that, it is rewarding to know that we have left something behind for the next generation to learn from and to take to greater heights.